Hi, hello, namaste. Welcome back to Needs of Children. We are discussing about 8th standard English medium social science. In that history, chapter number 12, the Cholas and the Hoysalas of Dwarasamudra. Let's come to the what are the very important learning points from this lesson. In this chapter, you learn the expansion of Chola Empire and contributions to different fields. The establishment of Hoysalas, contribution to religious, literature, art and architecture field. So, let's come to the among that, the first one, Cholas. Cholas, they provided their administration system, that is from 850 CE to 1279 CE. After the Pallavas, the Cholas secured a firm hold on many areas in Tamil Nadu, because before Tamil Nadu, which was ruled by Pallavas. After the Pallavas, Cholas, they secured firm hold in the areas of the Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka, and ruled from 9th century to 13th century. To them goes to the credit of spreading Indian culture in foreign lands. Even the places of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, they ruled from 9th to 13th century, and whatever they have given the contributions, especially Indian culture, it is spread even foreign lands also. They constructed grand temples, among that very importantly called as Brihadishwara temple is their wonderful contribution of the Cholas. They became famous by encouraging Tamil literature. They given contributions, especially encouragement for the language Tamil. So here the administration system, how they are provided, the map, it is describing about their achievements. It is towards spread in the foreign lands also. Here this is about the Chola Empire, the administration system of the Chola Empire. So among that, the Chola were under the Pallavas for some times and later became independent. According to Sangam literature, Karikala is the founder of this dynasty. The founder of Cholas considered as Karikala Chola according to Sangam literature. Vijayala Chola revived the kingdom and made Thanjavur as his capital. So after Karikala Chola, name called as Vijayala Chola, revived the kingdom and made Thanjavur as his capital. So here is, he is the Karikala Chola, the image of Karikala Chola. Karikala Chola administration system. One of the most powerful ruler, the very important king of Cholas dynasty, name called as Rajaraja First. An important king among the Cholas was Rajaraja First. He was a brave, a great warrior and able administrator. As the founder of Chola Empire, he strengthened its foundations and expanded his kingdom. So he was a brave, a great and a able administrator and a great warrior. As a founder of Chola Empire, he strengthened his foundations and expanded his kingdom. He overpowered the Cheras, Gangas and Pandyas when he was came to power. Building a naval force, he captured Sri Lanka. He constructed a naval force, with the help of that he captured Sri Lanka. We can see the predominance of Tamilians in Malaysia and Singapore. So the maximum people of Tamilians, they are lived in Malaysia and Singapore. Their influence in the political, economic and cultural activities of those countries can also be seen in those countries. Politically, culturally, economic, those are all the influence of Tamilians in these countries. They began overseas trade, which continued till date. So, especially a trade which is what they provided especially by Cholas, even today the influence of trade, administration, commerce, those it is influenced in these countries. So he is Rajaraja Chola, the image of Rajaraja Chola. The Brihadishwara temple built by Rajaraja Chola in Thanjavur is a very famous one. The one more image of Brihadishwara temple at Thanjavur. The Chola Empire weakened during the period of Rajendra Chola III, and the Pandyas could overpower them easily. So as when Rajendra Chola III was ruling, slowly the administration system of Chola Empire weakened, and he was overpowered by the Pandyas, and thus come to an end of the Cholas administration. So let's come to the what are the contributions of Cholas. So under the Chola administration, it's a map of Chola Empire. The contributions of Cholas among that administration. The Cholas had a set up able and efficient administration system. The kingdom, for the administration's sake, it has been divided into Mandalam, Kotwangi, Nadu, Kurram or community of villages, and Thara Kurram. So these are the administration system. The entire kingdom it has been divided. So there was a committee of subjects called Ur in every village. And there will be a self-government of villages. The foremost quality of the Chola administration was the development of self-governance of the village. The Grama Sabhas were the first Sabhas. Thara Kurram was a village. Every Kurram had a village committee named as Mahasabha. This was also called Perumguri. So the committee of village is called as Mahasabha. It is also called as Perumguri, and its members were called as Perumakkal. The members were chosen through the process of election. Only Sanskrit scholars and rich people were allowed to stand in the election. So this is the qualification to contest in the election. Only the Sanskrit scholars, they have to be participate in the election. Contest in the election. And their economic life. 1/6 part of land revenue used to be collected as a tax. So in case of any crop, if they are grow, under that 1/6. So out of 6, they have to be paid one part as a land revenue. A special attention had been given to the irrigation system, especially. So for the purpose of irrigation system, Cholas, they have constructed many lakes, and Bellanduru Lake near Bengaluru is one of these for the importance given by Cholas to development of irrigation system. They built huge pond in Gangai Konda Cholapuram. So here it is, Bellanduru Lake near Bengaluru. A huge pond in Gangai Konda Cholapuram. So here it is, a huge pond Gangai Konda Cholapuram. And their art and architecture contribution. The Cholas were basically Shaivaitas, and they built many Shiva temples. So one among that, the Brihadishwara temple in Thanjavur. So it is a 500 feet tall, and it is in a courtyard with 250 feet wide. Its shikara is 200 feet tall. So that is the a brief explanation about Brihadishwara temple. And one more, the Choleshwara temple was built by Rajendran. And the next, the Aparameya temple near Chennapatna. The Choleshwara temple in Beguru near Bengaluru. And Mukuteshwara temple near Binnamangala are the temples built by the Cholas in Karnataka. The temples used to function as a economic and cultural centers. The idols of Shiva, Ganapati, Vishnu, Durga and Kartikeya of this time are a very famous idols, are the gods worshipped by the Cholas. You can see the Brihadishwara temple in Thanjavur. So here it is a Brihadishwara temple image. Gangaikonda Cholapuram. Gangaikonda Cholapuram temple. So here it is also the one more image of Gangaikonda Cholapuram temple. So Choleshwara temple in Beguru. Mukuteshwara temple. So these are the images of idol images of Shiva, Vishnu, and then Ganapati. So these are the images they are used to, basically they are using Durga, Kartikeya images, the idol of Ganapati, idol of Durga. So idol of Ganapati, idols of Kartikeya, these are. At last the Cholas established many Agraharas to encourage education. One among that Uttarameruru Agrahara is a famous among these. The temples were centers of education. They were also centers of religious. So here it is the temple in Uttarameruru. And even, so they given the contribution in the field of literature. Their contribution in the field of literature. This was a period in which Tamil literature found all around development. So among some of the very important literary contribution, noteworthy works are Ramayana, which was written by Kamba. Even it is popular as a Kamba Ramayana. And next, Periya Purana composed by Sekilar. And Tirukkadeva's Jivika Chintamani. So these are the wonderful literary contributions during the period of Cholas. So that's it about today's session. I hope you have understood till now what we are discussed. In case if you having any doubts related to the concept of Cholas, you can comment in the comment box. I will solve your doubts. And I will come back with the next video. Until, keep watching my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you in the next session. Bye-bye. Take care.